Blessed are you who believed that what the word of God said to you will be fulfilled. Blessed are you when you do that. One of the fulfillments is prophesied in the prophets. He shall be peace. So if you're a person who lives out of the dream of God and out of the spirit of Christ's, how will you be peace? It starts sometimes from the inside by learning to pray and learning to center oneself, to not be knocked off course by things from the outside. It means taking control of one's ego and reducing its effect. Can't get rid of it. We're all bound by the sin of self-centeredness in some way or another. But to be peace sometimes begins by doing that work. The other way around, the outside-in stuff, the name of this series, sometimes means that we act peacefully and we struggle for peace. And when we do that, it alerts us to those things that touch our inside in a way that motivates us to work from a self-centered point of view. We can monitor ourselves as we try to be peaceful, as we try to be people of peace. When we encounter resistance to that, what happens inside of us? And then it's time to lean back in prayer and say, Lord, I was trying to be peaceful in this situation today, and I found myself reacting with some anger, and I don't know where it came from. Show me, Lord. Or I was working with a group struggling for justice and peace, and I found myself screaming at my opponents. What's that about, Lord? So it's a way of saying that if I want to be peace as the King of Kings is peace, as Jesus is peace, then I need to at least ask God to be in my life and heal me from whatever wound it is or from whatever sin it is that causes me not to act from a place of peace. So you can start where you want. That's what the Word of God tells us, that if you believe that Jesus is peace and that you are a person connected deeply to Jesus by your baptism, what is it that gets in the way of you or me getting there? How can we be peace? And it can start on the inside with good spiritual practice, or it can be alerted from the outside, which should drive us to reflection and spiritual practice. So as we close down on the Christmas season, it's a good question to ask ourselves. Am I on the way to being peace? May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.